Burkhard Heim invented this thing called syntrometry. And he said, compared to that, the work on the mass formula was purely relaxing. In this video, I want to give you an explanation about what the term actually means and a first idea about the whole concept of it and how important it is for our understanding of reality. Hello and welcome to Six Dimensions and Color. My name is Hannes Schmidt and I explain to you Burkhard Heim's worldview in understandable language and with clear examples. In the last videos, I told you about the dimensions 5 and 6 and that they are related to structure and their evolutions. So the problem that poses obviously here is how do you measure these things? How do you measure structure or evolution? That's something that obviously can't be valuated in terms of numbers. If we have these dimensions, then there are sets of values and there must be relations between these values, and the question is how do we evaluate all that? Burkhard Heim made a lot of effort to solve this problem, and he wrote this manuscript that was called Syntrometrische Maximentelezentrik, in short Syntrometry, which he considered his main work actually. As I said, the mass formula was a piece of cake compared to that, at least to him. That manuscript has only been published after Heim's death, and there has never been made an effort to translate it into English language. But if you want to check the German language, the German version, all the same, it is available under heim-theory.com. I put the link in the video description. So this video is probably the first time anyone ever tried to explain the whole thing in English language. So if you want to support me in my efforts, then I'd very much appreciate donation via bank transfer or PayPal or a regular contribution on Patreon. So admittedly, syntrometry is a bit challenging, but we must have an idea of what it is to be able to start thinking in six dimensions. In general, syntrometry is about terms and statements about terms and links between statements. For example, 1 and 2, ordinary natural numbers, can be terms. And I can say 2 is greater than 1. That's a very simple statement. Now, I could take the whole set of natural numbers and align them along an axis. And then first I would have to put them into an order. And secondly, on this axis, I can define the concept of distance. And in an abstract sense, the concept of distance is called metrics by mathematicians. Now, mathematics will turn out to be one special case of syntrometry. Syntrometry is much, much more general than that. One thing that we have to say goodbye to is the concept of transitivity, for example. I can say 2 is greater than 1 and 3 is greater than 2. Then from that I can deduct on the axis of natural numbers that 3 is also greater than 1. But in general, this does not apply to syntrometric statements. There are some parallels here to some kinds of category theory and probably homotopy type theory. If I could do this whole thing full-time paid, then I could make a genuine comparison. Anyway, for the start, let's use something easier than math and something more near to everyday life. Let's use words, English words to be precise. And let's put some words here in their basic forms, like morning, eat, eye, toast, tea, coffee, sun, etc. From these plain simple words, we can now form compound words like the morning sun, breakfast toast, breakfast tea. And we can conjugate over the verbs and say, I sit, I eat, I don't like. And now we can form simple sentences like, I sit in the sun, I don't drink tea. And from those, we can form even more complex sentences and compound sentences. And for example, say, I like to sit in the morning sun and drink a cup of coffee. This whole thing that contains the basic words and everything we can construct from them, we're calling our one big set and call it English language and put this down here. Something similar we can now do with German words and the German language. And the same thing we do for French and for Chinese. Now we have a set containing all types of human languages in the form of logical matrices. And logic in Latin means syllogism, and therefore Burkhard Heim formed the term syllogistic matrix, or contracted syntrix. Maybe now you can imagine that distances can be definable between these languages. For example, we can say the distance, the metaphorical distance between German and English is shorter than that between German and French. And German, French and English obviously have much shorter distances between each other than compared to Chinese. There's nothing quantifiable here, but you have a feeling of some kind of distance or relationship. Linguists spend a lot of time to analyze the relations and familiarity between all kinds of languages, and that results in such language trees, which you can see any kind of relation and metaphorical distance. And now you can understand what syntrometry means. It is the matrix of syllogistic matrices. So syntrometry is a system in which the concept of distance is extended to non-countable statements. As I said before, mathematics is one special case of it. And Burkhard Heim called mathematics the two-value anthropomorphic logic. But syntrometry allows statements about statements of systems, and put them into an order. Let's look once again on the order of natural numbers. There is a distance between 3 and 4. This distance is 1. There's also a distance between 4 and 5. And this distance is also 1. But in general, 1 is not the same as 1. That's a convention that is being put there afterwards. And this convention allows to say the distance between 4 and 5 is the same distance like between 3 and 4. But in general, that does not apply. And for most things in nature, it is really that complicated. Imagine that you have to reinvent the whole order of natural numbers. You just have a mingled set and have to put them into a new order. And then after you manage that, you have to negotiate with everyone else, because that task is also put to everyone else. Then you have to negotiate about how this shall be valued in general. Yes, it is really that complicated for most things. Mathematics is just one special case where this is very easy. Usually, perspective matters. If you look at that language tree, that's nothing trivial. That's the work of generations of linguists. So simply knowing that there are relations between sets of statements or structures, let's now use the term structures. Simply knowing that there are relations does not mean that you immediately know all kinds of all details of their relation. That may still be a hell lot of work. But you can state that there are relations. And that there must be general statements in some kind of superordinate system. And that is exactly what we are looking for. We want some system in which we can establish links between any kind of structures being statements and systems of statements, etc. The thing that confuses most people here is that we have to shed the concept of linearity of a coordinate axis and also the concept of transitivity. We have sets of values. These dimensions, 5 and 6, mean that there are sets of values. But it does not mean that anything that dwells in these dimensions can be broken down to ordinary ordered numbers. We will shed some more light on that in the coming videos. If you watch it until here, thank you very much for your patience. It will become clearer, everything, in the next video with some more specific with some more specific examples and ideas and terms from your everyday experience, or rather experience from science, in six dimensions and in color.